Working man.
Boa tarde, hello. Eu vou falar inglês. Hello, can you please introduce yourself? You and hello. You. Hello, hello. And tell please something about you. How long have you been in the party? And how it happened that you became communists? Because of what and how?
Okay, good afternoon. My name is Celso Costa. I'm in the communist party from 11, 12, 13 years ago. I started to work in a restaurant probably 20 years ago, and then I developed my conscious, political consciousness, and I since I can vote from my 18 years old, I always was member of the list of for Communist Party to the local council here in my hometown. So it was a growing process of consciousness mm-hmm. To develop and to become a member of Communist Party. And that's it.
Okay, and now what is your position here in?
I'm a member of the regional direction of the Communist Party here in Jelgav.
Okay, thank you. Katarina.
Hello, my name is Katarina. I've been a member of the Communist Party since the secondary school with the movement of the students in the 90 years. Then I was a little retired because I was a mom and spend more time for my family. And about 10 years ago, about 20 years, I came to live in Faro because I'm from Lisbon. And then 10 years ago, I came to Communist Party here in Faro.
Okay, thank you. So now it's a serious question. Do you think, a little bit about history, do you think Portugal Party or PCP, how you call it? PCP. Has ever had a chance to seize the power in the country by revolutionary means? Through the history.
In the revolution?
By revolutionary means, yes.
Well, our party has a very strong position in the workers, in the middle of the workers and the other the people.
Sorry for interrupting you, but you're talking about nowadays, yes?
Nowadays we are 98 years old.
Yes.
We are going
yes.
to celebrate the 100th anniversary in 2021. And we always had we are a working class party, and we've got a strong position in the worker class, of course, and also in the people in generally. The conditions for a revolution, how can I say this? We have to talk about history, the Portuguese history.
Yes.
We had the fascism for 48 yes, years yes. in Portugal. Then we had the revolution in 74. And probably in that time, 74, 75, the conditions and the conditions of in our country and the force of the party, the elements in maybe how can I say, I was not going to put it in better conditions in 74 and 75. Mm-hmm. But we were stronger in numbers, and the conditions in our country were more favor of a communist or a socialist revolution. But the revolution of 74 was a step, is how we consider it. It was a step for a different society. So in the times of the fascism, we were illegalized like many other parties. We were
since 1926. Yes.
26. So we were born in 21. Only 5 years, yeah. And a small, not very much positions. We were persecuted, jailed, tortured. Were tough and very tough years to be a communist. In 74, the revolution happened, and the numbers exploded. Like we were militants, like 1,000, and then 3-4 months later, we were 3,000, 300,000. And but the conditions for a revolution like we wanted to be, there was never be those conditions.
Mm-hmm.
The evaluation that we did in those days, there were not these kind of conditions. But the revolution of 74, because we say it's a revolution, there are some people that don't like to qualify it like a revolution, but we do it like this revolution because it stopped, it ended, put an end to the fascism society, and we set pace for another society with the socialism in the horizon, in the mirror. But the other forces were at strong, they were strong back then, and they had power enough to not to stop the revolution of 74, but to make steps backwards. I don't know if I can explain like this. We started a democracy with elections, and in this period of democracy with elections in the past 42-43 years, what we do and the numbers and the force we have does not say that we are ready to make a revolution the next day or the next week or in the next month. The conditions are not there and not prepared for this. But we still fight every day. We still fight the elections. It's not our main goal, the elections like the ones we had this month, 6th of October, for the parliament, the Portuguese parliament. We had the elections for the European Parliament in May.
And I have questions about both these things.
And we lost some votes compared to another elections before, but that's the process of going to another society like the one we want. It's a socialism and communism society. And we are working every day to make these steps for this society. Of course, we have to make the conditions for this revolution to happen. But it's what we can say. Or our position is the revolution is not going to be made in one day.
Oh, that's for sure.
probably this is what we wanted to hear.
Yes,
in this, the
main thing that I wanted to hear, do you think that PCP has ever had a chance to make revolution in history? So conditions through history, through 20th centuries were like that, that I think
the
maybe it was a moment. Maybe
the conditions is if we had the conditions, probably we were talking not if we had, but probably we are another history happened.
Okay, I see.
That's our position. It's not that we can say, no, we had this in that day, particularly in that hour, there were the conditions and we didn't take end of it. No, it's not like that. Because it was not one thing that you can do in one day or in 1 hour or in 1 week. We needed to evaluate the situation and we did that in 74 and 75, and since then we make reunions and we discuss about it, and those conditions in these 98 past years were never there exactly and specific there to make a step for it.
Yeah, okay. Katerina, if you have something to order, just tell me so I know.
Okay,
that.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Okay. Can you give me the microphone?
Yeah, microphone.
Okay. Now, as well as before, PCP has representatives in Assembly. Assembly de Republica.
Exactly.
And so. And at the same time, PCP represents itself as followers of Marxism-Leninism. Don't you see any contradiction in it?
No.
No. So, and...
There's no contradictions because it's like I said before, the elections, we are in a capitalism society. That's not our goal to continue to live on it. So that if we stand in our program, like in this small book says, that our goal is to walk for a socialist and a communist society, and if we see that the conditions are not there to make the step in one day to make the revolution, we have to maintain ourselves in this society and keep fight on it. We don't put ourselves on the side, like many others did. And the contradiction of fighting, like with their rules, but that's the society we have here in Portugal, and. We have to do it like that, because if we put a part of it, will be worse trying to convince the workers and the people to make this revolution outside or any other way. I don't know.
Okay, so
I don't see a contradiction with it.
Can you say that your parliamentarian methods are necessary? Or you think that it's possible to achieve socialism without revolutionary coup?
No, we don't say that. We say that to achieve socialism you need a revolution, and the revolution can be done in one day with strong and force and taking the power in one day with arms or fighting or that or. It has to be done like that because the other parts don't want to give up the power, but we can do it with 10 people, we can do it with 100, we can do it with 1,000 or many more, and to achieve the workers and the society to support and to maintain a revolution and the walking path to a society, a socialism society, you cannot do it apart of the political ways, of the parliament and the local council, and we still are trying. We use our parliament representation, that now it's just 10. We had 15 and now it's just 10. To organize the workers, to let the people gain consciousness of their force and their needs to walk in another different way than the political the right can you say this in English the right
the capitalism.
Não, política direita,
é que o right pode ser a boa, não é? A política boa, o right político.
There are left and right, I don't want to mean the right in a good way, but the right that we say in the back of 42 years, the governments here in Portugal only practice the right politic, not the left. And what we fight now in this phase, in this station, to walk to this socialism society, is to fight this politic and prepare the workers and the people to the advanced democracy. And with this the advanced democracy, like the one we had in 74, with the April Revolution goals and ideals, that we can go to another phase, another like station, that we can achieve socialism there in the next phase. So what we say is that the revolution have to be needed, of course, because capitalism have to be overpowered by a revolution. But these revolutions in Portugal is not gonna have the same characteristics of Russian, for example, 100 years ago, or other countries in the world. We have our own experience, and we have to evaluate every time the means, the ways, and the forces we have to do this.
Okay, so another question also about parliament, but about Europarlament. So PSP has also representatives in European Parliament.
Yes, it
and was. What do they do there, and what do you think about Europe, you know, in general?
What we do there? Well, we maintain, we have only two members. We lost one in the elections of 26th of May this year. And our two members defend Portugal in the UA and don't stand the economic union in Portugal. I don't know if you can understand this. It's this European Union is made to defend the maintenance of capitalism and the big countries and the powerful countries in power, and they don't care about the small countries like Portugal, and all they want is to approve laws there that favor them here in Portugal. And what we do is to fight these politicians, what we do there, these two members are part of the group, because you know in the parliament, European Parliament, it's made by groups. Every force in several in different countries are grouped in groups. The right, the socialists, the green, and we have this confederal group is 22 or 23 members, our two from the Portuguese Communist Party and some other left European Union parties and the Green Nordic Party. And what we do there is standing for the defense of our countries, like Portugal, like one example, the agricultural politics that the Union wants to be approved and wants to be in, applied in every country, that doesn't defend our agriculture, our Portuguese farmers. They want us to stop produce milk and other meat and other wine and other products, so that we buy from Germany or France or Holland. And we say no to that, and we fight these things. And what we take there is the Portuguese problems. Like here in Faro, when we had some problems here in the Ria Formosa. Ria Formosa is the aquatic system habitat here in the, in Faro and Olhão, a very big important ambiental and reservoir, so it's very important. And also there are some many fishermen and producers that pick up shellfish, and it's one of the biggest working places here in the Algarve. Probably there are more than 2,000 fishermen working there, and they are not represented in this in economic union. And so we take these their voices there. So it's a two-way. We start with. We vote against everything that is bad to our country, and we take there the voices of the workers, the problems of Portugal, and these kind of regional problems also.
Okay, and have you ever read, I'll try to translate the name to English, the motto of the United States of Europe by Lenin?
No.
It says just about the union of different European states.
I think I know what you're saying, this book, but I didn't read it. No.
Okay. So next question is, how do you estimate the party's successes in last few decades? How much the society changed?
The success.
Yeah, of the party.
The success, it's difficult. It's not difficult. It's easy, but I don't know if you want to make a success like what, in members, in representation, in votes, in the elections, because we don't measure ourselves. The success in votes, of course, we said before that we travel, we fight the votes. We go to votes in like a part of the battle, but we don't we are not stand only for the elections. If you were asking me the success in the last elections, that we dropped votes and representatives in the parliament, it's a downgrade in success. But if we measure the success of the Communist Party by asking how many workers fight for their rights, how many workers ask their bosses or are affiliated in unions, representative of their working places, or the consciousness of the people to fight for their problems. Well, we have to measure this success, and it's not easier to measure, is it, and or to say. Like a success.
Okay, it depends on what you really think about what is success for your party.
No, it's not a success. It's a path. It's a walk. It's a way to get to socialism. So and the battle is not it's fight or fought in better conditions sometimes and worse conditions in some other times. And maybe it's and in bad times where the offensive is more strong, probably is a retrievement of our positions.
And what time is it now? Bad or good for communists?
No, it's I'm not good. I don't want it to classify it like better or worse. It's not easy. It's not easy because we are fighting a big offensive, political and ideological offensive against the Portuguese Communist Party since 2015. How can I say this? You have to back to history. In 2015, there were a right government that was applying some worst kind of political that we had in these 42 years of revolution. Of democracy, and there were elections in October of 2015, and this government didn't have enough votes and deputies in the parliament to continue his government, but there were not a majority for another big party, but there was a majority of the left. Wing parties, and we said in 2015 that there were needed another solution for a government, not the right government PSD and CDS, the right parties here in Portugal, but there was another option that was the Socialist Party to form itself and only there by their own another government, and if they practice a different politic than the other ones before, that we can be with them in the and support the good things that they could the good things or the different things. The different politic that the other government before, and by saying this, these right wing parties could not form government, and this socialist party could form a government by their own. So, in a certain way, we stopped this very. Bad politics that were developed by these other parties, and we make us an interrupt. We stopped the right politics that were destroying our country. They sold many of our productions, the electricity productions, the transports productions, the banks,
the schools.
The banks were saved, the schools, the health, the many things that we had. It was attacked by these politics, and we said that it needed a change. Of course, when the other government was there, the big capitalisms were pleased by it. And when he say that they had this politic had to stop, they were not very pleased with ourselves. So they the offensive of the politic offensive against the Communist Party was bigger than, and in the last months they forced this offensive in the other ways by using the media, and we were under attack in January, February, well, since the last 9 months, and we still are in attack. Yesterday another thing happened here in the news, in the papers, and we are under attack, a very strong attack. No other political parties are suffer this attack in Portugal, but we stay strong. We had many meetings in these months to discuss the election results, and we say that we are still strong and have the support of many workers and many people. And so it's, if we measure the success by the, being supported with so many workers and people, then probably we are a better position. We are in a good position, not a better or worse, but we are a good position to fight the battle and keep going on our battle.
Okay, thank you. And here in Faro, there is a university, a lot of students live here, and can you tell me if
we have to skip this part.
Do you notice any growth of interest to left ideas among students, among young population in the last few years, maybe?
Well, about the university, I probably will not give you an answer. Katarina is a teacher. We don't have a good connection with the university and the students. It's a very important thing, it's a very important place, but we don't have many connections there. Of course, the right and the right wing politics are in there, of course, like the left ones. But what I can say here in Portugal, of course, in Lisbon, Coimbra, Porto, maybe it's different. But here in the Algarve, I think the main characteristic is not being left or right, not making an option. The students. The students are more not focused in left, in the left teams or things or politics, mm-hmm. and or right, not left or right, but more for makes this.
O que queres dizer?
Opa, não estão preocupados. They are not very concerned in this.
In não, this política, politi- mas
with politics, maybe they are. they don't have these. Discussions.
They're not interested in politics at all, in general, you mean?
I don't think so. I think one thing in the young people, they have concern with so many problems in our country, in the world, but here, the government and the capitalism, they construct an idea of the political is bad, and young people think, oh, the political is bad, And the political is not bad. It's the most important thing in our life. It's in the everything, in the price of the thing we have, in everything. Politics is everything. But the idea that politics is bad made the young people get away from the politics. But for the other side, I'm a teacher and I'm in the schools. They have concerns and they are worried about the environment, about other things, but they don't have in this moment the right place to do it. They have esvaziar empty. The government make emptied all the places where the students can be listen and organize, like students associations. Now the students association, it's most parties and not discussion, not in that. Stay, make the young people afastados,
walk
away from the politic, but they are interested, and we have to find also a way to get close to them. But my comrade says, and he is right, in the big cities, Lisbon, Oporto, Coimbra, they have a big, a biggest movement of students. Here in Algarve, it's a few.
Estamos organizados lá?
Yeah. It's we have a biggest organization in the big cities.
For the universities here in Faro, we don't have this connection.
We have a connection, but it's
more with students, more with teachers than with students.
Yeah,
we have 3-4 teachers that are communists. We have 2 workers there. We don't have a student. We don't have a student. No.
We have more teachers in the other levels of graduation. In the basic school, in the secondary, in the university, it's a few, just 3 or 4, 5. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. And does PCP participate in trade union struggling?
Yes, of course.
And
of course.
How you are connected with them, and do you help them to organize their fightings?
Yes, of course.
Strikes.
Every day. And
and
she's and she can answer for it because she's part of a union, the teacher union.
Yeah, I can speak about my union, of course, but I think it's the same in the other. In the other workers' union, but we struggle every day. We go to the work locals. We speak with too much people. We organize him for fight for his rights. We organize for meetings here or in other cities to fight against the bad politics. To fight for them rights and in all of that struggle, I believe that will be essential, if important, for the socialism society that we want and we fight every day.
Yes, but don't you think there is a risk to turn into trade unionism, that you just start to fight for better conditions, but stop the idea of changing the system?
Better conditions,
the better conditions and the rights, because you can change a society if you have in the bad condition, if you don't have rights in your work, if you don't have rights in your family with your sons, if you don't have rights in your work, if you don't have a good salary, the change of society, it's a process, and you have to walking in that process, and that process have too many things. Eu não sei explicar isto em inglês. O processo tem muitas coisas, tem avanços, tem recuos e portanto, e os direitos das pessoas. My comrades speak English better than me.
If you want, you can speak Portuguese and we will translate it later.
Ok. O processo de mudança de uma sociedade implica muitas coisas, portanto, implica um aumento da consciência dos trabalhadores, implica um aumento de salários, implica uma elevação da condição de vida dos trabalhadores e do povo, e portanto, isso vai-se fazendo, e portanto, a revolução ou a alteração de uma sociedade, a mudança de uma sociedade, é o resultado deste processo, portanto, não é de um dia para o outro, e a luta sindical, a luta junto dos trabalhadores, também faz parte deste processo rumo a uma sociedade socialista. É mais ou menos isso.
Mais ou menos, sempre lendo. Obrigada.
Okay. Mas Elsa.
Okay. And can you tell me what are the main difference or disagreement between PSP and other left parties in Portugal?
Well, there is not much of a disagreement. We have a program that we say that the socialism and communism is our goal. We have these many pages here that say how we want to go there and with who. And the other left parties, they don't have this thing in their program. Many of them, they don't have even a program. Some parties feed themselves in the news, in the daily news. It's difficult sometimes for us to fight for some rights, for some other politics, and when you have to say first that the daily news about the animal. The animal problems, or the lack of rain, or sometimes it's these small things that we fight with. Of course, we have a position of all these small things, but we have a program, and we know where to. How to go there and where to go, and many of other left parties don't have. And some other parties, like the Socialist Party that is in government now, what we say about them, it's a party that practice the right politics. They say that themselves that they are from left. We don't
they
say.
They aren't.
We don't say they are not a left party. What we say is it's a party that practice the right politics, because in all major decisions that stand for the economic union and for the big capitalism in Europe and in Portugal, they practice this favor of them, not in the workers, not in the people, not in the production, not in the so.
Ok.
Olha, mais uma, se calhar só terminávamos, não? Porque já é 7 e tal. Just one more question, because about the hour.
Okay, okay. Then the traditional blitz poll in the end of...
The traditional?
Blitz, short questions.
Ah, okay, okay.
Just answer quickly, without long explanation.
Okay, let's try.
Stalin or Trotsky?
Stalin or...
Stalin or Trotsky?
I don't see it on this.
Why that question?
That's just the questions that we always make for everybody.
Okay.
Because they have different visions.
Why not Lenin, had... Albert Pujol, Marx, and Engels?
Well, the main.
And,
okay. What do you think of dictatorship of proletariat?
That discussion in Portuguese, the Communist Party had an end in 15 years ago, 40 years ago. We still fight for it, it's one of our goals. We don't use this term anymore, because when we fought the dictatorship of fascism for 48 years, when we were... And it's in our program, it's not anymore. We changed the way of saying it.
Yeah, to because, what?
Not to the statement of the workers. It's not a term that we stop using it and we start a new one. I have to think about it. If you want, like a... This blitz answer, I cannot answer like this.
Okay.
It's just a confusion of the word in Portuguese, dictatorship, because we stopped the dictatorship in 74 or 48
yeah.
years, and we start if we started to say, let's go for another dictatorship.
Yes,
the
I
people
understand.
Even our own communist members didn't understand.
Yeah, I see. But can you say in Portuguese, which word do you use now? Oh, you didn't...
You
didn't create...
A ditadura do proletariado. Nós deixamos de usar esse termo por causa da ditadura, confundia-se com a ditadura do fascismo.
Sim. Eu acho que, no fundo, houve até uma evolução técnica, um bocado por aí, de linguagem.
Sorry, when you start to support speaking Portuguese, it's very fast. I don't quite remember what we can do... What
okay.
term you use?
Okay, I'll
Sorry
read
about
the program.
That.
And was it socialism in USSR?
If there was?
Yeah, if there was.
So socialism onde?
If I in the na União Soviética.
Yes.
Okay. The revolution and they wanted to, yes.
E a elevação das condições de vida das pessoas, a cultura, as artes,
but
a growing up of the condition of the persons and the culture. We have here in Portugal people from the Russian that have a strong culture and many studies. It's part of the revolution. The people in Russia, I think, was before the revolution was very poor and analphabet and don't have the basic things, and then they have a growing up of our conditions of life. I think it's
What we have to say here is that if when you ask this question, if there was socialism in Russia or in USSR or in any other country now, in Cuba or in other country, is to me needed to be made in a different question. What kind of socialism was there in USSR or what kind of socialism it's in Cuba or in North Korea or China? It's different from ours, from our goal of our in our program, and because it's different kind of countries and different kind of revolutions, and will be different kinds of socialism. There is not one socialism that is this to be applied in different countries.
Okay, and the last question is, how do you see future in communism?
How do we see future? Communism is the future of the society, human society.
And how do you see it?
How do you...
A sociedade vai ser essa, não há outra forma.
Yes, it's...
Não podemos voltar atrás. The capitalism is, they are, will have an end. It's scientific.
It's scientific.
It's scientific. So
yes, I mean that,
the future is socialism.
Details, how you imagine it? How you picture it?
Oh, very good. for the workers and the children, with art and employers and homes to everybody. Now it's not possible.
It's one thing. It's difficult to imagine the conditions in the future to be, but it's the future of human society, and we go there, and then we have to fight for it, and then we see how it is then.
Maybe you also can answer just a little question. Do you somehow communicate with foreign comrades in different countries, and specifically in Russia?
We have not in the Algarve or ourselves. We don't do that. We have an international section in the Communist Party. It's in Lisbon, and yes, we do have connections with many other working and left wing parties around the world. I think it was this month, 2 or 3 weeks ago, there was this international working meeting where in Turkey. I think it was in Turkey. And we have this very big
meeting.
Okay,
thank you so much, and I wish you luck and good conditions.
Okay, thank you, Alexia.
Bye bye.